It's a roti, becomes stuffed roti. So I ate it, but not with that tough taste of parotta. So obviously, oil provides the palatability, the texture, the look, and obviously, we have a craze for the food when it is full of the oil. A toast with butter and without butter, just think about it. So there are obviously some benefits of the oil intake of oil. This called the membrane functions, visual and brain functions, steroids and bile salt synthesis. You know better than me. And obviously there are some problems also on the higher intake of the oil, that CVD and CNS, carcinogenesis, osteoporosis and arthritis, renal stones and eczema. So that's why doctors always prefer to have a little less consumption of oil. But we oil technologists do not agree with that. We always have a oil, but have a good choice of oil, have a better choice of oil. You first select your oil before you go with it. Before you avoid it, better to select a good choice, a balanced fatty acid composition oil for your daily consumptions. Please don't avoid it, as because it hampers your daily life, your regular physiology also, and many nutritional aspects. So some major food uses of fats and oils. We have about 85% of fats and oils available in India is meant for edible purposes, principally as cooking or frying, and in producing specific products for bakery, confectionery and chocolate industries. Those who avoid those who take only boiled vegetables and etc., they must have oils from the other sources like biscuits, confectioneries, chocolates, cookies, etc. You cannot avoid the consumption of oil in your daily life. So our dietary oils mostly comprises of groundnut, soybean, sunflower, cottonseed, sesame, mustard, sunflower, rice bran, coconut, and obviously palm kernel, palm oil, rather than butter, ghee, vanaspati, margarine, and fish oil. According to region, we have many food habits. Like we eastern and northern region people have the mustard oil as our basic oil or cooking oil. Otherwise, in the western they have groundnut. In southern they have coconut. Principally the soybean and sunflower. And nowadays rice bran is coming up as a as refined oil, white oil and etc. We have a secondary oil composition or consumption like all these oils. But palm, what about palm? Mostly we do not aware about the consumption of palm oil directly, but obviously we have indirect consumption, huge consumption of palm oil, as because of our confectionery industry, our bakery, our chocolate are all, and obviously the eating out, the food we are eating out are obviously comprising of the palm oil due to its such of its benefits. Mostly it's the fatty acids we know, the unsaturated fatty acids. Unsaturated fatty acids are again divided into monounsaturated fatty acids and polyunsaturated fatty acids, which you know as MUFA and PUFA. And there is another N6 PUFA, and PUFA is divided in N6 PUFA and N3 PUFA, which have according to its position of double bonds, we named it as N3 PUFA and N6 PUFA. And we have a villain fatty acids named as trans fatty acids, which is nothing but as 18-1 fatty acids, the double bond is in trans position. So there are also a few minor constants also present in the oils and fats. Mostly approximately 97% to 98% is triglyceride in the oil composition. Otherwise, there are some 2% to 3% unsaponifiable components, which comprises of sterols and sterol esters, hydrocarbons, fatty alcohols, triterpene alcohol, and original vitamin A or beta carotene, tocopherols and tocotrienols. All the above components play important role in nutrition and health. I think the more than a oil could have impact on your health and nutrition, these minor components play a very important role in vitro as well as in vivo also, to make the oil stable or unstable, and also in vivo you can have the benefits also. So usually we have some metabolism. Please forgive me if I am wrong, as because you are the expert in the subject. The variation in the structure of fatty acids define its physicochemical properties. All the physical and chemical properties of a oil or triglycerides, and also the nutritional properties also, depends on its fatty acid composition and the positional distribution of the fatty acids. These saturated fatty acids, mainly palmitic acid and stearic acids, are converted by delta 9 desaturates into palmitoleic and to oleic acid by desaturates and chain elongation enzyme systems. This oleic acid gives rise to short omega 9 series of metabolites, that is lauroleic and myristoleic acids. And linoleic omega 6 and linolenic omega 3 are converted to a series of N6 and N3 long chain PUFAs, arachidonic 24 N6, icosapentaenoic 25 omega 3 N3, and docosahexaenoic 26 N3. And these three fatty acids are involved in the structure of most tissues and in their function also. And so we call them as essential fatty acids, as because our body do not synthesize these fatty acids, but these are very essential for our daily nutrition and health. So the 23 and 24 fatty acids of the N6 series and the 25 acids of the N3 series are converted in various organs of the body by cyclooxygenase and lipoxygenase enzymes into a group of materials collectively called as prostaglandins, which comprise the prostaglandins, prostacyclics, thromboxane and leukotrienoids. You know, all these actually regulates our body functions. So to produce, from producing hormones to balance all the physiological activities in our body, this prostaglandin controls all something. So we prefer this. So as we are always saying that PUFA is very beneficial of our health, PUFA is very much required for daily requirement, etc., etc. So usually we have a very generalized chart that if we have a total fat, that is if we have 35% of our energy from fat, which is WHO recommendation, that our total cholesterol level increases, LDL also increases, HDL decreases, and triglyceride also increases, blood clotting factor not yet confirmed, blood pressure also increases. If we have saturated fatty acids, total cholesterol again increases, LDL decreases, HDL presently we don't have any idea, triglyceride also increases, blood clotting factor increases, blood pressure increases. So we have, here we can see that saturated fatty acid is not good for our health. And then again for the MUFA, that monounsaturated fatty acid, total cholesterol decreases, LDL decreases, HDL not known, triglyceride not known, blood clotting factor decreases, blood pressure also decreases. And what about the trans fat? Is all bad. It increases total cholesterol, LDL, decreases HDL, increases triglyceride. And N6 PUFA also, we have less total cholesterol, less LDL, less HDL, and have blood clotting factor increases. And for N3 PUFA, this total cholesterol, HDL, LDL, we are not sure about that. But obviously, the total triglyceride decreases and blood clotting factor also decreases, blood pressure also decreases. So altogether, every fatty acid have some positive and some negative effects, except we have the saturated fatty acids. Next, come to the point, the oil palm. The oil is obtained from the fruit of palm tree, and it is largest produced edible vegetable oil in the world. Largest produced. The major producer of palm oil are Malaysia and Indonesia. And productivity, the high photosynthetic rate of palm enables it to produce 8 to 10 times more oil per hectare per year than other oil seeds such as rapeseed or soybean. And it has an output to input energy ratio of 9:1 compared to 3:1 for other oil seed crops. And that is saying that palm oil, somehow the higher production of palm oil can damage our climate also. It have a huge emission of carbon dioxide. As it said, the environmental scientists are saying that. So what is the composition of palm oil? It has saturated fatty acid about 48%, monounsaturated fatty acid about 40%, PUFA about 12%, and non-glyceride factors, that is unsaponifiable components, and 1.2%, which comprises of tocopherol, tocotrienol, and carotenoids. And it is naturally semi-solid at room temperature and does not require hydrogenation for use as a food ingredient. We know solid fat has a separate use, have a distinct uses. These solid fats, why do we hydrogenate oils, liquid oils, why do we hydrogenate? As because we require these solid fats for many specific purposes, especially for spreads, for confectionery, for chocolates, for bakery, etc. So, but this palm oil you can use directly at it is a semi-solid oil in a room temperature. It has a unique fatty acid and triglyceride profile, which makes it suitable for a number of food applications. It's a unique fatty acid. What is this? I come to this. Oil could be refined, bleached, and deodorized from reasonably good quality crude oils, which simultaneously removes few minor components also. Oxidative stability and just one point. It is a naturally. This oil is obtained from the fruit palm tree. I missed the point that it is not solvent extracted. It is a cold pressed oil. As someone is saying that you don't take the refined oil as because the bad palm oil is mixed with it. Solvent extracted palm oil is mixed with it. So hexane is present there. Don't go with that. The palm oil is a cold pressed oil. No hexane is used in extracting the palm oil. Oxidative stability of the oils depend on its fatty acid compositions and presence of antioxidants. The inherent stability of palm oil is quite high, 1.3, which makes it suitable as frying oil. Preferably as, because it's a very stable oil, it can withstand the repeated frying also. Inherent stability relates to extent and types of unsaturated fatty acids and relative reaction rates of unsaturated fatty acids with oxygen. So as a stable oil with this stability of 1.3, palm oil can withstand repeated frying also. Since the mid-1990s, palm oil has been cold pressed and refined, bleached and deodorized and bottled for use as cooking oil. It is blended with other oils for mayonnaise and salad oils, to prepare mayonnaise and salad oils. And it is hydrogenated to produce vanaspati, bakery spirits and confectionery fats. Can be fractionated. This is a very important point. Palm oils can be fractionated and used as cooking oil also. So can be further processed into palm shortenings, used as a replacement ingredient for hydrogenated fats in a variety of baked and fried foods. I think the fractions of palm oil will be covered by Dr. Mondal, so I skip all this. There is three fractions of palm oil as it is, and fractionated palm oil, palmolein, and palm stearin. This palmolein can be again fractionated to have a superolein with a higher amount of monounsaturated fatty acids and a less amount of saturated fatty acid, which is the best available frying oil in the present day. So importance of a presence of a balanced fatty acid composition with almost equal saturated and unsaturated fatty acids in palm oil. Relatively stable to oxidative deterioration due to low level of linoleic acid and virtual absence of linolenic acids. There is an 18.2 and 18.3 is almost, 18.2 is in a very small amount, 12%, and 18.3 is almost nil. So that the palm oil is very stable, and palm oil is unique among vegetable oils in having a significant amount of saturated acids at the two position of triglyceride. As we know, why mother's milk is so important for a baby, for everything. Why? As because that mother's milk have palmitic acid at two position, so as to palm oil. As the higher amount of palmitic acid present in the palm oil contains a sufficient amount of palmitic acid two position, which in turn have a beneficial effect on our health aspects actually. As you know, the pancreatic lipase is one three specific. So when this fat is hydrolyzed in our stomach, it remains the palmitic acid in two position, which again prefers to have a good binding with calcium and etc. So we always have a preference for the palmitic acid in two position, which the palm oil has. Probably for these few reasons, palm oil is good in for health also. And crude palm oil contains about 1 to 2% of minor components, including carotenoids, tocopherols, tocotrienols, sterols, triterpene alcohols, terpenic and paraffinic hydrocarbons. And besides, phospholipids and glycolipids are also present, which are removed during refining. And what is carotenoids? Carotenoids are natural chemical compounds that give crude palm oil its orange-red color. If you see this, palm oil is totally red in color. And this crude palm oil is the richest source of carotenoids. As compared to the other vegetables, oils like 15 times more than carrots and 30 times more than tomatoes. You know how carotene is important for our health. The most active and important form of carotenoids found in palm oil is beta-carotene. And many carotenoids contain vitamin A, which is an effective antioxidant and helps strengthen the body's immune system and reduces the risk of cancer, heart disease, and cataract. And what about sterols and tocopherols? Palm oil is rich in tocopherols and tocotrienols, which is also known as vitamin E. In fact, no other vegetable oil has a much vitamin E compared to palm oil. Vitamin E is a powerful antioxidant capable of reducing the harmful types of oxygen molecules, that is free radicals in the body. This means they may help to protect you from certain chronic diseases while delaying the body's aging process. Latest research shows that tocotrienol from form of vitamin E reacts more effectively than tocopherols. This tocotrienol is very important, which is not present in other oils, only palm oil. So effect of palm oil on blood cholesterol, I have to go early, no? So we have risk factors of CHD that may be influenced by diet. Our elevated levels of serum total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, serum triglyceride, and reduced levels of HDL cholesterol. These risk factors are really modulated by fat content in diet. A high intake of saturated fatty acid in the diet may lead hypercholesterolemia. On the other hand, PUFA have a hypocholesterolemic effect in humans. Studies saying that due to 1:1 ratio of saturates and unsaturates in palm oil has not significant effect on blood cholesterol. Moreover, palmitic acid is actually neutral in their ability to raise both serum and LDL cholesterol. And on arterial thrombosis, dietary fats have also implicated in the biochemical processes related to arterial thrombosis. Dietary saturates are generally pro-thrombosis, whereas PUFAs seem to have the opposite effect. Palm oil was found to be an exception to these general findings when rats were fed palm oil diets, and antithrombic tendency was observed even in comparison to a highly PUFA sunflower oil. The process of formation of arterial plaque is always facilitated by dietary fats. As we know, the fats are always are termed as a villain for anything regarding the atherosclerosis. But consumption of a diet predominating in palm oil did not result in an increase in arterial lesion compared to other commonly used oil. So in cancer studies also, total fat consumption has been positively correlated with the cancer studies in several epidemiological studies. A high fat diet promotes cancer development than a low fat diet. The tumor promotes effects of PUFAs have been remarkably consistent. But tumor yield in the palm oil group is significantly lower, probably because low amount of linoleic acid and due to the presence of beautiful minor components. So what will be the bottom line? Palm oil is a wholesome and nutritious edible oil, reduce risk of macular degeneration and cataracts, helps to improve energy levels in the body, beneficial in prevention of cancer, boost hormonal balance, elevates strain on cardiovascular system, prevents vitamin deficiency in pregnant women and children. So I always, as a person of MPOC, I told all the benefits of palm oil, but as a whole, every oil has a negative point also if they consume about in a high. If you have a high intake of oil, every oil has a positive and negative side. So don't make the palm oil as a villain, but we have done series of experiments on the frying up with the palm or palmolin, and we have seen that this palmolin and palm oil can withstand the maximum cycles of frying which we usually have in our roadside food or in the restaurants or other worlds. So in the home we can avoid the palm oil, but we are not cannot be afraid of palm oil when we are eating out or have something as a confectionery and bakery products. So these are the all references. If you go for the Google, there is a lots of studies done and published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition, Lipids in Health and Diseases, Journal of Lipids, and also there are beautiful article by Dr. Kallan Sundaram of MPOC once. Then, so you can have all the references in the our dear Google in the. So thank you very much. I don't know how much I can. Judiciously done my duty, but anything against oil, I am ready with to answer. But anything about the health, I am not that much of confident about that.
Thank you, Dr. Mahua Ghosh, for a comprehensive presentation on main fats initially, and then on the positive aspects of palm oil. Thank you, ma'am. We will take questions after the second lecture is over. And now we welcome Dr. Kingsuk Kumar Mondal. He's working as consultant, as international consultant for palm oil industries, and he will be talking about its value-added products. Dr. Mondal. He has having a rich experience of more than 30 years in processing quality assurance and product development in oils, specialty fats, and oleochemicals based on palm oil and palm kernel oils, with special references to bakery shortening, puff shortenings, margarine, cocoa butter substitute, and cocoa butter equivalent, after completing his PhD in oil technology. He has developed process technology and increased yield of refining of palm oil and during fractionalism of palm oil. He has developed specialty fat products like CBS and CB, along with bakery shortenings, puff shortenings, and margarine, food fats and fertilization limited, Teddy Palle Gudem. He has developed all specialty food products based on palm oil like bakery shortenings, puff shortenings, Imami Agrotech Limited, and made all these products acceptable in the market, and also developed their specialty fat products. He has also developed project on bypass fat based on palm oil and did marketing report of the same in India. He's an international expert for the preparation of cocoa butter substitute, both from palm kernel oils, palm oils, non-lauric fat like sulfat, shea fat, by dry and solvent fractionalization for making cocoa butter equivalent. So, Dr. Kingsuk, your time.
Hello. Good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Kingsuk Mandal. My Professor Muha Ghosh, she is my junior, definitely, but she is a highly learned lady. I think she has given a very beautiful lecture to give her aspects of palm oil, the basic thinking. I have nothing to say more than that, whatever she has told. Still, I will say something. I think I will try to explain the effects and some palm oil aspects also. My first topics will be the trans fat and the effect of trans fat on the human consumption, and how can we replace this trans fat. It's an old story in European countries. Initially 1950, below 1950, all the bakery shortening and puff shortening and everything was being made by the lards, animal fats, you know. But after 1940, the people discovered if we hydrogenate the liquid oil, we can get the similar property of the lard. That is, they are replacing all the animal fats by the hydrogenation process of the vegetable oil, converting to the same compound. And from 1950 to 1990, almost all industries throughout the world used the hydrogenated vegetable oil to make all type of puff shortening, biscuit shortening, cake shortening, and also for the frying purpose also. You understand? That is, all of us, including India, including Europe, including USA, everybody has taken that hydrogenated vegetable oil. But during this hydrogenation, there was a formation of trans fat. It's basically a chemical word, you know. All of you are doctors. I don't know how much you are aware of this trans fat. This trans fat is basically, just you can help me. This trans fat, basically, both the hydrogen atom in the same position. It's a double bond. Both the hydrogen in the same position, it is called cis fat. But when this both this hydrogen becomes in the opposite position, it is called trans fat. In the industrial hydrogenation of the liquid oil, what happens? This C18-1, at the oleic acid and linoleic acid, when this is hydrogenated, it comes to the trans position instead of cis position. And people were knowing it, that during this hydrogenation, this trans fat is being produced. And since it is well accepted in the eating world, nobody was objecting. So we are all eating trans fat. Trans fat containing oil for frying, for bakery products, for biscuits, etc. But 1990 onwards, it was coming to know, 1990 onwards, it was coming to know this trans fat has got an adverse effect on the human body. It was proved that it is increasing this coronary heart disease. That's a major thing. It was increasing the LDL, which is bad for health, and it was decreasing the HDL, which is good for health. And it was proved throughout the world that it is giving a very severe heart attack and heart-related disease. So people started thinking, and this trans fat is produced in a different way. Almost three types of trans fat is produced. One is industrially formed. You see, what I was telling, by the industrial hydrogenation, we are getting trans fat. Another is formed by the normal human milk. There is also some trans fat, but in a very lesser account. In the industrial hydrogenation process, we are getting almost 30% to 40% of trans fat. But in the naturally formed process, it was having only 3% to 4%. So why do companies, that's I was telling just now, why do companies using this trans fat? Because it was easy to available, easy technology, and easily acceptable to the human market. But since it was giving a very strong bad effect, you see, I was telling that trans fat is your bad LDL, and it is trans fat increasing is reaching of developing heart disease. And it was proved throughout the world it is doing that. Now, which foods contain trans fat? As I was telling, all the foods containing either biscuit or chocolate or your frying oil, frying food, or the pizza, everything was containing trans fats. And as a result, we are increasing the heart-related disease, and also there was later on it was proved. It was increasing the lady was, there was a reference of 2000 ladies' health was checked who are having the higher content of trans fat in their blood. That was increasing the possibility of breast cancer. It was examined that it is increasing the, in the male, it was increasing the possibility of prostate cancer along with these things, and it was increasing the possibility of diabetes. Now, throughout the world, it is well known that trans fat has to be banned. By any means, you have to decrease the content of trans fat in your frying food. These have already told, I think, what is the effect on the health. Now, people started thinking, then what we will do? The trans fat is very bad. Somehow we have to replace the trans fat. Trans fat is giving all adverse effect. So some different thinking was thinking. Somebody told, okay, go back to the original butter. There is normal butter which contains high amount of saturated fat. But this saturated fat also gives some bad effect. So it has to be taken in a very minimum quantity. Some other people told, okay, produce something which is equivalent to the, which will give equal effect of trans fat but will not harm your body. That is, the genetical engineering. Genetically modified soybean oil, genetically modified canola oil, that is rapeseed oil, was used in place of trans fat. But again, it was not known. It was already thought that at the time of making trans fat, converting animal fat to trans fat, people were telling trans fat is good. Similarly, scientists started thinking that today we are telling genetically modified soybean oil or genetically modified canola, if at all is good for trans fat, tomorrow something will be discovered, then again it is giving a bad effect to the human body. People were afraid. The another possibility is the use of oil, vegetable oil, which is a purely vegetable oil, having no trans fat, but gives the similar effect in the cooking medium. One of these major oil is palm oil and coconut oil. You see, this palm oil, as was being told by Professor Moagas, I already have given some indication, the beauty of this palm oil, due to its unique fatty acid composition and triglyceride composition, it has got, it, have you seen, I don't think you have seen palm oil or you have given concentration to palm oil, the quality of palm oil, it is to some extent semi-solid fat, you know. You will see if you just take it in a bottle or a long jar, half of the oil will become solid and half of the oil will remain liquid. So it is almost giving a character of that solidified, hydrogenated fat. But since palm oil is obtained directly from the tree, it is tree-borne oil, it has got no trans fat. Or during the processing, refining, bleaching of trans fat, during the duration, so some minimum content of trans fat is in any oil. That is only 1 to 2% of trans fat. But using this trans fat, you can get the same compound, same fried product or same cooked product which you are getting from the your trans fat compound. This system, I am not going into details because I have to get another similar paper. This is the refining of process of palm oil and the palm oil fractions, what Mohua told me to explain. This palm oil, whatever we are getting from the tree oil, it is refined and bleached, then and then comes to the market. And Malaysia and Indonesia is the major producer of this palm oil. They are producing about 26 lakh tons of this oil per year. The and maximum, their economy is almost dependent on it, and they are exporting to throughout the world. And India is one of the major importer of this oil. In fact, all Indians are eating palm oil, you can say, in this form or that form. And this not only this palm oil is used as it is used if different fractions is used. That is, palm oil during the interaction, we can get palm olein. Palm olein is a very good frying oil, very good medium for cooking of the deep frying. Palm stearin. This is also very good medium for making banaspati. I am telling another possibility. Not only this palm oil is used as it is, but it is used by some different chemical process. This is called interesterification process. If palm oil is palm oil or its fraction like palm stearin, it is taken a soybean oil or liquid oil with it and doing some chemical interesterification reaction. No, without doing hydrogenation. During hydrogenation, we form the trans fatty acid. But if we are doing a separate chemical reaction, which is called interesterification reaction, and if this palm oil is doing the interesterification reaction, what that triglyceride structure just gets changed. I'm talking in some chemical language. I don't think everybody is understanding it, but I have no way. In a single class, I cannot make you understand all these things. You just try to understand this hydrogenation process produces this trans fat. But if you go by the chemical interestimation process, this without any hydrogen gas, this does not produce any trans fat. So by interestimation process, palm oil can be converted to any vanaspati product or any bakery product, which gives the all products which you are eating. So you can say in our country also this trans fat has been banned now. We cannot. Even 3 to 4 years back, we are knowing that trans fat is bad, but due to the government regulation, we are helpless. But now our government also has restricted it to keep it below 5%. Sorry. Even our country also, it has been for the central government FSS, it has banned our trans fat is now content up to maximum up to 5%. And you see, a very common example I am giving you. You are all taking banaspati, that is dalda, a common name. I think we are all taking banaspati either for frying or for cooking purpose. And all these banaspati, even before 2-3 years, when it was not banned in our country, was being done only by the complete hydrogenation of the liquid oil, either palm oil or soybean oil or a rapeseed oil or a mixture of palm, whichever oil was cheaper, it was being taken. That means we are all taking all this by this hydrogenation process, we are all taking this 30-40% of trans fat in our body consumption. But after this restriction, we have been all constrained to not make hydrogenation. What alternative we have gone? We have used this palm oil only. And by doing the one of the fraction of this palm oil, that is palm stearin, with liquid oil like soybean oil or rapeseed or whichever is cheaper, By doing intensification, we are making the same vanaspati. Same vanaspati with same character, but without any trans fat. We are maintaining the trans fat below 5% as per Indian government level, but in the abroad country, it is maintained below 2%. And by 2020, it is going to be more banned. America, USA, and European countries has taken a decision. They will go to zero trans. That is, there will be no addition of trans. Because, as I was telling you, it was having a very serious bad effect. So even our country has been so much restricted, and this 5% ban, whatever has come from the central government, we are pressurizing the government. All our scientists, oil technologists, and the peoples like you are pressurizing the government. No, no, 5% is not sufficient. In Europe, in USA, it is 2%. So we must go to below, or it is somewhere it is below 1%. So you all must go to below 1%. And that is going to come another 5 years. This government also will declare. Though this Banaspati lobby or this marketing lobby, whoever doing this trans fat by the EG process, they are not very happy. But they are also now being bound to do it. Okay, next. So why palm oil is so suitable? As Moha has already told you, it has got a very balanced fatty acid composition. So it is giving a very good effect in making this. The alternative to trans fat, as I was telling, the alternative to trans fat is one of the major alternatives to trans fat, not only in India, in USA also, they are importing this palm oil 7 times more than that they were importing in 2020. Because initially this USA was little restrictive towards this palm oil because it has got a high saturated fatty acid composition. But now, after doing several nutritional research on it, it has been almost proved. Since it has a balanced fatty acid composition, so it is not doing so harm as they were thinking earlier. Okay, this another thing, it is a rich in vitamin A and etc. etc. Palm oil is a reasonable replacement for trans fatty acid, what I was explaining to you in all these things, why it is reasonable to fatty acid. And I am Dr. Kingsuk Mandal, and expert on this oil. If any of you have any question, please come on.
Thank you, Dr. Mandal, for a comprehensive presentation. Though you have shown that palm oil is again good with less of trans fat, but our aim is to reach zero level of trans fat in coming days. So,
in 2020, in coming days. 2% in 2022.
So ultimately 0%. Any questions for Dr. Ghosh and Dr. Mandal? Dr. Ghosh, if you please come to the dais to respond to some queries. So both of you please say. Can you have some questions?
Yeah, okay. Question.
Kindly introduce yourself and
myself, Dr. Suryavanshi, Professor and Head of Community Medicine. Dr. Suryavanshi, Professor and Head of Community Medicine, TN Medical College and Nair Hospital, Bombay. I have only one question. How much should be the recommended daily intake of palm oil for an average Indian reference man?
So actually, as a WHO recommendation, we should have 35% of our energy from the fat altogether. So, and what about the total? You have the saturated, unsaturated balance in all these 35%. So that's directly... Can we say nothing about the direct consumption of palm oil? If we want to have 35% energy percent only from the palm oil, then we have to calculate how much we have to take.
So average Indian person means is a 40 years age with 60 kg of weight. The calorie requirement average is 2,000 calorie per
2,000
day,
calorie
roughly.
Per yeah.
If it is a manual worker, it may be 3,000.
Yes.
On an average.
Average 2,000.
So 35, you said percent calorie. That means 700 almost. Calorie he should get from the palm
from
oil.
From the fat.
From the fat.
From the direct and indirect consumption of fat. Okay. Total, you have so much of indirect consumption also. Yeah. If you have fish, mutton, daily chicken, we also have some consumption of the fat. So direct consumption is a total consumption of fat.
So minimum, how much it should be? Minimum?
Actually, our per capita consumption is very less. Till it's only 40 to 50 grams we have. The per capita consumption somewhat, there is a varies from village to urban sector. So naturally, if you that, then I said everything about the good thing about the palm oil. Obviously, there are some bad thing also. It's not rich in PUFA. It's low in unsaturated. So if you have a balance, so that's why nowadays we are coming up with a blended oil. If you see, there is a lots of blended oil in the market. There is a palm rice bran, palm soybean, palm sunflower, rice bran sunflower, rice bran soybean, rice bran corn. So we nowadays we are preferring to have the blended oil. So to have the maximum benefits from our oil, to have the all the benefits, the benefits of the fatty acids, benefits of the micronutrients. If you have the at least some amount of rice bran oil every day, you can have the original and squalene in your diet. So we nowadays we don't concentrate only single oil. Go for the blended oil, and you change your oils periodically. Change so 3 months for mustard oil, then you go for the can you check for the soybean oil also. No oil is complete. Can give you the complete nutrition or all the benefits. So either you go for the blended oil or you change periodically your oil. The every zone we have a basic one oil as a basic oil. Like we Bengalis and eastern regions have mustard oil as our basic oil. All cookings, regular food are cooked in the mustard oil. But when we go for the savories like puris, parathas, chowmeins, etc., we will have some either rice bran oil or sunflower oil or soybean oil. So in that case, if we have the blended oil, then it's a better option. Always don't take palm oil as it is, but as a blend, one of the oil you can take.
Proportion, how much should
proportion. Be proportion? It's mainly in India with the blended oil nowadays, blended oil is permitted in ratio not less than 20%. One, if there is only blend of two oils, and one oil should be in the proportion of 20%. Now, industrial people is asking for three oils to have greater amount of PUFA in it, like chia oil or fish oil in the blend oil. But if you have a 50-50 blend, we have a beautiful blend of palm and rice bran, 50-50 blend. We have beautiful blend of sesame and rice bran, 50-50 blend. Again, we have so much of corn agro products on blended oils. So it's minimum 80-20, maximum 50-50.
Thank you, ma'am.
One more. Yeah. Well, I'm Professor Mansoor from Bangladesh. I'm working as an advisor of the Department of NCD, Bangladesh University of Health Sciences. Yeah, it's a very nice presentation. Sorry that I was late in here, coming here. In Bangladesh, we use usually soybean. Majority people use soybean.
How does rice bran also very popular
rice
in Bangladesh?
Rice bran is a bit costly than
but
soybean.
Don't you use the mustard oil?
No, mustard oil we used
very less
long ago, but long nowadays we don't.
Now mostly soybean.
Yeah. Mostly soybean. I want to know, in comparison to palm oil and soybean oil, which one is
better one?
Better. And another thing is, blended oil, so far I know, is not available in our country.
Okay.
Either we have to single oil, sunflower, olive oil, etc., etc., but no blended oil. So, is there any blended oil available in India?
India, it's so lots of.
Okay, so what
actually
is
actually now blended oil is the modern trend,
yeah.
Blending of oil. And regarding soybean and rice bran as palm, oh. I can comment. Both the oils have definite advantages. Soybean is rich in linoleic acid, which is very essential fatty acids. And at the same time, as due to the presence of that unsaturated, soybean is little tender in oxidation. So you cannot repeat your frying in soybean. And moreover, soybean is also rich in tocopherol. And where the palm is not that much of rich in PUFA, but it's rich in MUFA, somewhat they have 50% of MUFA. It is very stable oil. It is very, very stable oil. You can have repeated frying on the palm oil. So it's, and moreover, that palmitic acid in two position also have a beneficial advantage. So every single oil has its own advantage and disadvantage. So that's why we are now promoting the blended oil. But if you have as a sole oil in your home or in your country, I do prefer that. So you can use both of them actually. Palm oil is the important part of palm oil is stability. It's a very stable oil.
Can we blend it in our home?
Yes, obviously.
We can buy palm oil.
Ha, 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 ha. It's a very good choice. And moreover, palm oil is a better choice. Palm oil, if you go for the, if you, your current country, palm oil is available, it's a better choice. Because it is rich in PUFA, rich in MUFA and PUFA, less in saturates actually.
So it mixed with
ha, ha. If you want to mix, please mix rice bran palm, soybean palm, sunflower palm. Sunflower palm is a good option. As sunflower give you the sufficient amount of PUFA, palm give you sufficient amount of saturates and other things actually.
Thank you, ma'am. The last question, sir.
Yeah. I have two questions. One was, India has recently, I think, raised the import duty on palm oil. 80% or something.
No, not so palm oil. There's a fall. Actually, India is a country where the every country wants to send something there, a product to India is because of a huge number of population. That crude palm oil, we have a lesser duty on crude palm oil. We have a higher duty on the refined oil to sustain our industry, our refineries in India. The duty on the crude palm oil is very less. That will be, and that too is fixed upon the amount of carotene, beta carotene, and free fatty acid present in the oil. With the excise duty is fixed, and for the refined oil, the import duty is quite high. To just to have the industries not to import the refined oil from other countries, and so as the refineries of our countries become shut down. A few months ago, according to SAARC agreement, Bangladesh has that advantage. According to SAARC agreement to promote Bangladesh import export, the country has agreed that they don't have to pay the duty on the refined oil. So then Indian importers, what to do? They are importing the oil to Bangladesh and their crude oil to Bangladesh or refined oil to Bangladesh, and then they are taking the oils from the land custom to our country. Once there, the small industries are quite, they are taking in a tanker, it's 200 metric ton, 300, but Imami once realized that it's a boon. So they have a huge tanker, it's a huge vessel on refined oil. And then RDI what has done? So now they have immediately stopped the refining from Bangladesh and imposed a huge duty on refined oil.
Yeah. Second question was, if the oil settles down, part of it, palm oil settles down, and if you use the upper layers, is it healthy or not?
Yes, ready. That's we done in the industry, the fractionation of palm oil. We are settling separating the saturated part, saturated parts and the liquid part. The liquid part is less saturates, more unsaturates, and the solid parts is more saturates and less saturates.
Thank you, I'm Dr.
And this solid part can act as a solid fat as a vanaspati. It acts like a vanaspati without trans fatty acids.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm Dr. Shyam Ashtekar from Nasik Community Medicine.
Thank you very much, Dr. Anupam.
As we come to the end of this session, I thank all the chairperson and speakers for such a wonderful session, and we had a lot of participation was also there, and such an interactive session. I congratulate the participants also for this session. Now I would like to invite Dr. Saleem Khan for felicitating our speakers. Dr. K.K. Mondal. Sir, this point will be good for photograph. Dr. Saleem Khan to please felicitate Dr. K.K. Mondal. A big round of applause for him. And I request Dr. Saleem Khan to felicitate Dr. Mahua Ghosh also. Sir, please stay on the stage. We'll have a group photograph later on. And I request Dr. Narendra Mahajan to please come on the stage and felicitate Dr. Saleem Khan. Dr. Narendra Mahajan to please felicitate our chairperson. So can we have a group photograph? Dr. Mohit.